Hi, I'd like to take the opportunity to demonstrate our new weather protection boot for LMR-400 for an end mail and LMR-400 cable. It's our WPB-400-NM. First, we're going to have to go through a connector demo, also a quick connector demo to do this. So first, you have your LMR-400, and we already have a nice clean cut on there, but we're going to take the opportunity to demo our tool here, our CCT03 cutting tool. Just place it on a cable, spring-loaded, place your finger through the hole, and just turn that around the cable a few times, and it's going to snap off. It's going to make a nice, clean, sharp cut. You take the boot, and you could use some lubricant, but you don't need it with this boot here. You just get it started. It's going to slide back on the cable, like so. At that point, you take your WSB-400 boot, and this you will need a little bit of lubricant to get it started. It's a nice, snug fit. This is what seals the back end of the connector. Just put a drop of our rubber seal there. Get the boot started on the cable. You can slide that boot back. You got both boots on the cable. You take your crimp ferrule, slide it onto the cable. You take your CST-400 tool. You take side one, you make sure there's nothing stuck in there. Place it onto the cable, like so. Push down on the thumb switch and spin it. And once that thumb switch bottoms out, make at least one full revolution of the tool. Leave the thumb switch depressed and pull it. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna take that pellet right off the cable, and you're gonna take the adhesive layer off with it. Nice, clean, sharp cut. Flip it around to side two. There's a little deburr tool there in the tool. Place that over the center conductor, deburr it. Now you wanna make sure you're set for a crimp, as this tool is, and just like an old-fashioned pencil sharpener, just spin that right around the cable until it spins freely. Like so. You got a nice prep there. At this point, you just take the round wire braids, fold them back a little bit, no need to comb them out or anything. This connector's got a beryllium copper spring finger contact, so there's no soldering. Very easy, and it's called an EZ400 NMH-X. You get it started over the outer conductor, it's a nice snug fit by design. You push it and turn it, and it'll ride right up on the center contact. It'll bottom out. You take the ferrule, you bring the ferrule forward, and you'll notice the braid wires end up right at the back ring of that connector. That's by design. Now you take a 429 hex. We have a number of tools that you can use to get that hex dimension. Here's this is our CT400/300 crimp tool. And you want to crimp it just once right at the very back of the connector, like so. And this is what it looks like. You don't want to move that tool back and crimp that again. If you do that, you're going to crush the jacket, you're going to change impedance, change the electrical performance of the interconnect. So you crimp it just once. Now you notice there's ribs in the back of the connector here. There also happens to be ribs inside this boot, this WSB boot, that are going to snap onto that and create that seal. This stuff dries pretty quick. It's biodegradable. This rubber slide, put a little more in there. And you slide that boot up. It's a real snug fit over the cable. You might even heard it snap there, but it just grabs onto those ribs in the back of the connector there. Now to move forward with our demo here, we're going to take that little dust cap off. Got a little piece of sample fitting here, like an end female bulkhead, which mimics what you'd see on a you know, anything with an antenna or a component with a bulkhead connector or a panel connector. That's what you're looking to seal to. That's what that boot is going to seal to. So we'll take our end mail and we'll mate it. And since I'm right-handed here, I think I probably have to flip this around there. And we'll bring this boot up, slide this boot, our WPB boot, and we'll slide it right over that connector. We'll just have to work it a little bit. And there you go. That thing is sealed, you know, weather sealed, it's IP67 weather sealed to that bulkhead connector. Real simple. No special tools. You didn't even have to use any lubricant. And for whatever reason, a year from now or something, you want to run some kind of tests or something, you want to get back at that connector, all you do is you pull that back and you have a totally protected connector. So you don't have to use this boot. Some people may be saying, hey, there's some redundancy there. Why, if you're using this boot, why do you need this boot? Hey, this provides some strain relief. It's very cost effective, doesn't cost a whole lot. It seals that back end. Why wouldn't you want to use it? So I'd recommend using the WSB boot and the WPB boot. Especially if you got something, you know, that is going to be installed out in the elements for the long haul. Just really rugged, real simple. Thank you.